So why is Altrecht after me? Altrecht is the psychological care in Utrecht. First, a simple question. Would you like to be sacrificed as a victim for some corrupt state like the Netherlands? Put in jail for eternity when you are a whistleblower, or killed in the most horrific way when you're a woman? And then the perpetrators get away with it because of a royal pardon, and the excuse is that the girl committed suicide. Of note here is that it's not allowed to commit suicide and not allowed to assist someone to commit suicide. Both are punishable with jail time and should be investigated thoroughly, including an examination by a mortician. I have three enemies in the Netherlands. Mitros, that is the housing association. They want me out of my house for exposing the dirty little secret, which is an illegal brothel. The police, they want me out of my house to keep them out of trouble with the law themselves, because they were looking away for too long, and, well, they even went there to play along and have some parties. And Altrecht, well, they are more than willing to put me away without a court order to be checked over by a psychologist to keep things on the wraps. And probably they want to keep on the wraps that the king is insane himself. But you've heard that on my audio before. The next problem is the huge amount of money we will receive if we were to present our case to a foreign judge. So psychopaths in charge think, let's kill the whistleblower somehow and his girlfriends too. Meanwhile, they're abusing my girlfriends non-stop and laughing while snorting cocaine, torturing and killing them. That's why I hate the Netherlands. Yes, I can listen into this 24/7 basically, because this house is not really soundproof at all, at least not all of the houses. Let's start with the royal pardon. How does this work? Easy enough. You are the errand boy of the king and does do his dirty work. If you get caught, he has a royal pardon for you before you know it. Because of corruption, your chief, that's also corrupt, will say, you are so unlucky, it's so unfair for you to be fired. Let's give you the same job you had. Then we can party again and we kill some more innocent people because we're almighty and we're friends with the king. An insane king can and should be abdicated or dethroned, so to speak, because his royal immunity does not allow for him to walk the street with a Kalashnikov. The same applies for the royal pardon, where he has his friends kill for him and then use the royal pardon to give them an out-of-jail-free card as if it were a monopoly. That's not how the law should work regarding royal immunity. He also abuses his power in regards to the law of state secrets, where he applies it to human beings when it's not allowed to do so. What a great country the Netherlands is. The newspapers are not allowed to print this story because of the law of state secrets. Well, our freedom of the press. I'm starting to wonder if the Minister of Defense has some knowledge about the secret projects that are going on in the Netherlands. I was talking about them before. Because there is no intervention from the army, and the police can do in Utrecht whatever they like. Why is Altrecht after me? Well, conspirators can not arrest me without proper reason, but under Dutch law, someone can receive a crisis intervention without a court order. That means that they put you in a mental hospital or a hospital to be checked over by a psychologist, and, well, they look if you are ill or fit. But these kind of interventions take about 24 to 48 hours. And then what happens? Well, my testimony in court will be of less importance because they'll say, well, you have been in a mental hospital before, so you're probably a little bit crazy. At that point, Marissa will hijack my home with permission when I'm temporarily put in a mental institution, and she will have the key of my house thanks to either Mitros or the police. The goal is to get rid of me as the whistleblower and to make one big illegal brothel from both staircases with 8 residents each on the numbers 67 and 65 of the Graatverroggeweg in Utrecht. I'm on 65 too, by the way. How do I know this? Because Altrecht, in the person of Koen van Deursen, keeps harassing me with how are you? He keeps bugging me, he wants to meet me, he wants to come to my house, and I keep telling him, you have to leave me alone. I'm not ill, I have nothing to say to you. This is after I sent the first audio file where Daniela was saying, I want to leave, I do not want to be a hooker. When they keep harassing you, then you know this is corruption, And, well, I guess it's against the oath of Socrates. That's the oath that says you have to help people instead of bullying them or putting people in the care that don't deserve it. And I'm a whistleblower, so they want to put me in care because then they can play along with their games. The police, Mitros, and even the municipality of Utrecht did multiple care alerts to make sure that Altrecht can somehow put me in an ambulance and put me away to neutralize me as a whistleblower and a possible, witness. But they do not care about the women that are tortured and killed next door. Then who is the conspirator? I have too much knowledge about the sex network that since this week has a 16-year-old victim, the daughter of a judge. Yes, you heard me correctly. Since this week, they have a 16-year-old daughter abducted from a judge, and they're raping her, they're torturing her, they're putting her under tattoos, and the police doesn't give a shit. This is why I'm thinking, why don't we burn all those conspirators? And the next time, I'll talk about Machiavellism. That's the worst kind of psychopaths for females. And that's what Marissa is.